It is day 9 in Almaty at the 28th Winter Universiad. Action heats up as the games wind down. In this summary, we'll go back to yesterday, ski jumping for the men's team competition. In hockey, the final men's quarterfinal between Kazakhstan and Sweden. Then from today, in speed skating, it's the men's and women's mass start. And in cross-country skiing, it's the women's 3x5 kilometer relay. From yesterday, on February 5th, this is the Sumkar International Ski Jumping Complex, where the men's normal hill team competition took place. Temperature about minus 10 degrees here in the evening in Almaty. And there you see the athletes gearing up. Each team has 3 jumpers, and they'll each jump twice. First up for Poland, this is Krzysztof Mietis. 17th in the normal hill individual competition. And a good jump there for the pole. His total 246.2. That jump was 97 meters. Now Ance Lavtazar. He's of Slovenia. Finished just ahead of Mietis in 16th position in the normal hill individual. Good telemark landing there for him. 97 meters. And his total, 253.3. Now for the Russians. This is Alexander Bajanov. He had a top 10 placement here in the normal hill competition. And here for his second jump. Pretty happy with that one. Good landing. 103 meters. And his overall total, 267.1 points. And there are the standings after one of 3 groups. Now we move on to Stanislav Bila. Bila was 14th in the normal hill competition. He was part of the Polish team that won bronze in this team event back in 2015. And a nice solid finish for him. 99 meters, and we'll see what he scores. His overall, 254.6. Now Andraž Modič. The Slovenian was 5th in the normal hill competition. A good landing there. 101.5 meters. 259.3 points he'll contribute to the Slovenian team. Now Roman Trofimov, the second Russian jumper. He also had a top 10 finish in the individual competition, finishing 9th. A little bit of a stutter on the landing there for Trofimov. But a really good jump, 104.5 meters, 259.7 points. So the Russians remain on top, Slovenia in second, and Poland third as we head to each country's final jumper. This is Kantika of Poland, 7th in the individual event. Almost 89 kilometers an hour at takeoff. And he's happy with that jump. 104 meters, 261 more points for Poland. Now, Aljaž Vodan. The Slovenian just missed out on the medal podium in the individual, finishing fourth. Trying to put some pressure on the Russians. And again, happy with that jump. Slovenia looking to hold on to at least that silver medal spot. 104.5 meters, 271.2 points. Getting congratulated there by his teammates. Now Mikhail Maksimochkin. The Russian won silver here at the Normal Hill individual competition and was also part of the Russian team in 2015 that won the Normal Hill team event. And the big Russian there, good jump, and he knows that's gonna be enough to put them in gold medal position, 263.1 points. And the Russians, with 789.9 points overall, finish in top spot. Slovenia gets silver, and Poland the bronze. The final men's quarterfinal game took place at the Halyk Arena here in Almaty yesterday. Kazakhstan up against Sweden. Kazakhstan comes in 3-0. They've outscored their opponents 35-0. There you see head coach Sergei Starigan. For Sweden, they're 1-2 with 5-0 losses to both Kazakhstan and the Czech Republic. There's their head coach, Per Goran Tarnlund. But they did have a 15-0 win over China that propelled them into this quarterfinal. Daniel Hansen will start in goal for Sweden. It'll be Pavel Polyakov for Kazakhstan. Huge Kazakh crowd here at Halyk today to cheer on the home team. Early on, a tough break for Sweden right off the stanchion, and Konstantin Savinkov with a chance in front, but Daniel Hansen betters him with a good stop. Later on in the first, a Swedish turnover, and Savinkov will get everything into that one as he beats Hansen on the nice feed from Bertilev. Kazakhstan up 1-0. A few minutes after that, Kazakhstan keeps coming. Nice move there by Kirill Savitsky. He jumps in front for the chance, but Daniel Hansen seals off the post and denies it. With just under 4 minutes to go, Kazakhstan again with some pressure in the Swedish zone. That shot from Ibrahimov ends up out of play. Now there's a shot again off the mask that time of Hansen. Then a little bit of pushing and shoving after the whistle. You see there Axelin getting into it. There's the shot right off the mask of goaltender Hansen. So that's where we'd end after the first period. 1-0 for Kazakhstan. Now to the second. Another turnover at the blue line. Grenz will feed Mikhailis, but Hansen stands tall and makes the save on the 2-on-1. You get a good look right in front. Mikhailis had to kick that one up to his stick. Kazakhstan keeps coming. Mikhailis again. Now Petrov is stopped by Hansen. Nice little pass there, but Petrov gets in a little bit tight on the Swedish netminder. Slapper there from Stepanenko, but stopped by Hansen. The Swedish goaltender standing up big time for his team here right now, keeping them in this hockey game. Now in front, Ekholzen with the chance. He gets buried after that. You see him here battle off Saldin, but can't beat Hansen. Under a minute to go. Hrebajkov fans on that one. A relatively easy stop for Hansen, considering all the other tough ones that he's made throughout this contest. Sweden holding into this one, only down one against the heavily favored Kazakhs. But early in the third, Savitsky will tuck one there through the pads of Hansen on the scramble in front. Just barely beats him, and Kazakhstan goes up 2-0. A few minutes later on the power play. Great play there as Mikhailis bats home the rebound. Savitsky and Grants had chances just before, but you'll see the great hand-eye coordination here from Mikhailis as he bats that one past a prone Hansen. 3-0, Kazakhstan now up. Late in the third. And Sifirov will put this one away, the fourth of the night for Kazakhstan. Asatov with a nice pass. And that should seal it for Kazakhstan's trip to the semifinal. Kazakhstan will now move on to the final four. They will take on the Czech Republic as they defeat Sweden 4-0, outshooting the Swedes 42-8. So as mentioned, Kazakhstan and the Czech Republic, along with Russia and Canada in the men's hockey semifinal. Beautiful aerial shot there of the Mideo Sports Complex outside of Almaty. This is the final day of speed skating. And this is the mass start. First the women. This is the first time this event has ever been competed at a Winter Universiad. And as you can see, very different than most long track speed skating events. It'll bear a little more similarity to what you see in short track. But of course, this is over a much longer distance. And there you see with helmet number 13, Anna Pristalova of Russia. She recently set a personal best in the 500 meters of 42.05 seconds in Moscow. But this is, of course, much longer than that sprint distance. She was 20th here in the 1500 meters and 12th in the 5000. Behind her in helmet 18, you just saw there Anna Muzika of Ukraine. She's trying to keep pace with the Russian. Also in this race in helmet number 2, Jun Yejin of Korea. She won a gold yesterday in the team pursuit. There's Pristalova, now onto the final lap. You can tell her legs are burning, just trying to get through this final stretch. And she's beaten out not just June, but also Nene Sakai, silver medalist in the 5,000 meters and a bronze in the team pursuit. And there you see Pristalova working her way towards the gold medal. And she will cross in a time of 10 minutes, 43.74 seconds. The silver will go to Sakai of Japan and the bronze to June of Korea. This is a points race. So you'll see the standings there as the athletes earn points throughout the course of the race based on where they are time-wise. And now we'll go to the men. And there you see the start list for the final. Athletes to watch out for here. Silver medalist from the men's 5,000 meters here at Universiad, Saitaro Ichinoue of Japan. He's in helmet 7. In helmet 10, Lee Jin Yong, a gold medalist yesterday in the team pursuit. And Alexander Razurinov of Russia, he was 8th in the men's 5,000 meters. He's in helmet number 3. Also, Alessio Trentini, the Italian you see there, just in second spot. He's in helmet 13. And right now in top spot, helmet 8, Robin Gruben of Norway, followed closely there by Trentini. And then in behind them, in helmet 16, Thomas Melin of France. But now moving in front, Ichinoue, you saw him briefly there. There he is, right in top spot, followed by Lee of Korea. They're starting to pull away a little bit. Ichinoue still looking comfortable, but you can tell with the look on the face of Lee, he's starting to tighten up a little bit here. And now they make their way here to the final straight. And Ichinoue with another gear gets into it. He'll take the gold medal. Time of 8 minutes, 56.98 seconds. Lee will finish second. Just behind 8 minutes, 57.18 seconds. And Razorinov of Russia, just over 9 minutes at 9:01.11. And there you see Ichinoue as he overtakes Lee. Lee just could not find that extra push. And the second medal for the Japanese skater, he earned 65 points. Lee with 40. And there you see on the women's side, Prishtalova wins gold. Sakai and June with silver and bronze. And there is Ichinoue of Japan. Joined on the podium by Lee and Razorinov in the mass final. We go now to the Alatau Cross Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex. Beautiful sunny if chilly day here outside of Almaty. This is the women's 3x5 kilometer relay cross country ski event. As the athletes get warmed up, and there you see a look at the starting area. Each team will have three skiers. They'll do two laps of the 2.5 kilometer course. And you'll see the exchanges after every 5 kilometer segment. And there we are, underway. And in front there, from Kazakhstan, that's Anna Shevchenko. Won a gold already in the mixed team sprint and a bronze in the 5 kilometer pursuit, as well as in the individual classic. And this was set up to be a battle between Russia and Kazakhstan throughout most of this race. And there you see Lilia Vasilieva of Russia just in front of Shevchenko. Vasilieva won the gold in the individual classic and then silvers in the 5 kilometer pursuit and the sprint classic. Coralie Bentz of France just in behind them there. There you get a good look at Bentz. Bit of a gap between her and the front runners. You can see about 16.4 seconds there at that split. Now we get ready for the first exchange. And you'll see here, they almost get a little bit crossed up. Quickly sliding over there is Repnitsnina of Russia. And for Kazakhstan, there you see Olga Mandrika. Mandrika was a bronze medalist in this event back in Trentino in 2013. And there's the exchange for France. They're just under 35 seconds back. That is Léa Damiani of France. The first group of skiers skied classic style. Now it's freestyle. And now we come up to the second exchange. And again, you can see Russia and Kazakhstan right side by side. And for France, the exchange will now send out Céline Chopard-Lallier, who won a silver in the mixed team sprint earlier here at Almaty. Irina Bikova of Kazakhstan briefly took the lead, but then you can see shortly after surrenders it right back to Anna Nekayevskaya. Nekayevskaya won the gold in the 5-kilometer freestyle pursuit. And you can see she started to build up a fairly significant lead here in this third leg of the relay. Looking very strong up the hill. And there is Bikova of Kazakhstan trying to keep pace. Come now to the bell lap. Nekayevskaya with a rather wide margin. 14 seconds right now on Kazakhstan. And now we'll head right to the finish. Nekayevskaya about to win her second gold medal here at Universiad. So Vasilieva, Repnitsina, and Nekayevskaya will win gold in a time of 42 minutes, 25.1 seconds. There's Bikova. She will cross the finish line to give Kazakhstan a silver. So it's Bikova, Mandrika, and Shevchenko. They finish 52.1 seconds back in a time of 43 minutes, 17.2 seconds. And there is Chopard-Lallier of France. She will cross to give the French a bronze medal. So Chopard-Lallier, Damiani, and Bentz. They're 1 minute 46.1 seconds back in a time of 44 minutes, 11.2 seconds. And there you see the final standings here in the women's 3x5 kilometer relay. And there are the winners. Russia wins gold, Kazakhstan silver, and France will win the bronze medal here in the women's relay.